So hello friends, welcome to my channel. I am coaching center. So today I am going to explain your 12th standard physics first chapter, that is electric fields and charges, electric charges and field part 4 videos. So this is the last part of this chapter. So let's come to the topic. So dipole of in a uniform external field. So consider a permanent dipole of dipole moment P in a uniform external field E, as we are shown in diagram. And there is a force QE and Q and A force minus QE on minus Q, and the net force of the dipole is zero, as you know, since E is uniform. So magnitude of torque QE is equal to QE into 2A, so therefore 2QA E sin theta. So therefore we can put as T is equal to P into E, and thus the torque Q will tend to align the dipole with the field E. When P is aligned with E, the torque is zero. So therefore the situation when P is parallel to E or anti-parallel to E, in the either case the net torque is therefore zero, but there is a net force on the dipole if E is not uniform, and therefore it is easily seen that when P is parallel to E, the dipole has a net force in the direction of increasing field. When P is an anti-parallel to E, the net force on the dipole is in the direction of decreasing field, and in general the force depends on the orientation of P with respect to E. So this brings us the common observation in the friction electricity. Let us know about the continuous charge distribution. So here therefore the sigma delta E they have taken, and therefore delta E therefore sigma is equal to delta Q by delta S. So we can take as lambda is equal to delta Q by delta L, and therefore we can take it as P is equal to delta Q by delta V. Like that only we put the Coulomb's law, that is delta E is equal to 1 by 4 pi V0 and P delta V into R square into R. So that way we will change the element of charge, and P and R is a unit of vector. We will take E is equal to 1 by 4 pi V0 and delta and delta V by R square into R. So next law, let's know about Gaussian law. So here they have taken a radius of spiracle. Here you can see electric flux, in that they have taken the radius of the sphere, radius of the sphere R. So therefore the radius of flux the flux through an area delta S is delta theta is equal to E into delta S is equal to Q by 4 pi E 0 by R square. So R square and R into delta S. So therefore the delta S and R have the same direction. Therefore delta is equal to Q by 4 pi E by theta R 2 by delta S we will take. This is the total flux through the sphere is obtained by adding up the flux through the area. And next we will take what will take means Q by 4 pi V 0 by R square into the 4 pi R square. So therefore it is equal to Q by E 0. So electric flux through a closed surface is equal to Q by E 0. So Q is the total charge enclosed by S. So therefore we will take the total flux theta through the surfaces D1, D2, T3, where D1 and T2 represent the cylinder, and T3 is the flux through it. So therefore T1 is equal to minus ES1 and T2 is equal to plus ES2, and S1 is equal to S2 is equal to S. So let us note some important points regarding to the Gauss law. So some of the important points regarding to this law. Gauss law is true for any closed surface, and no matter that its shape or size. So it is true for any closed surface, and the size and shape does not matter. And in the term Q on the right side of Gauss law includes the sum of all the charges enclosed by the surface, and the charges may be located anywhere in the set. So the Q denotes all the charges in that. And in this situation, when the surface is so chosen there are some charges inside or some outside, the electric field is due to on the left is due to the charges, and both inside outside, yes, the term Q on the right side of Gauss law however represent the total charges inside the S. So it represents the total charge inside the Gauss law. and Gay's law is often used towards the much easier calculation of the electrostatic field. So it is used for a much easier calculation of the electrostatic field, and the surface that we choose for the application of Gay's law is called as Gaussian surface. And you may choose any Gaussian surface and any Gaussian law, and you can apply any Gay's law. And finally, Gay's law is based on the inverse square dependence on distance contained in the Coulomb law. So the distance contained in the Coulomb law, on that one it is based. And Gay's law will indicate departure from the inverse square law. Departure from the inverse square law, Gay's law indicates. So these are the important things about the Gay's law. They may ask in your final exam. So next law, applications of Gay's law, and the other topic, one topic is left. So let's come to the application of Gay's law. Other one or two topics is left. Application of Gay's law. So first is field due to infinity long straight uniform charged wire. So it has a charge density that is lambda, and the wire is obviously an axis of symmetry. Suppose if we take the radial vector from O to P, if we take the radial vector that rotate around the wire, the points P1, P2, so obtained completely equivalent. So therefore, we have to consider a pair of line P1 and P2 of the wire as shown, and the electric field produced by the two elements of the pair when they are summed give a resultant electric field which is radial, and this is true for any such pair, and hence the total field at any point P is radial. And the magnitude depends only on the radial distance, that is r. And to calculate the field, you imagine a cylindrical gaseous surface that is shown here in the figure 1.29, and it should have the cylindrical part of the surface E. It should have, and as you know, the surface area of the curved circle is 2πr, and where the length of the, where L is the length of the cylinder. So therefore E into 2πr and is equal to lambda L by EO. So therefore E is equal to lambda by 2πEO or into N. This is the, where N is the radical unit of the vector, and E is directly outward to if the lambda is positive, and inward if the lambda is negative. It is, so this is the first thing, the field due to infinity long straight uniform change wire. And if the field due to uniform changed infinity plane shape, if it is it has infinity plane shape, so we can take the gaseous surface to be rectangular parallel across the area A shown in the figure, and the only the two faces 1 and 2 will contribute to the flux, and the electric field lines are parallel to other faces, therefore do not contribute to total flux. But still the unit vector of to surface is 1 is in a minus x direction, while the unit vector to surface 2 is in plus 2 direction. So therefore the flux through the Gaussian surface is 2EA. So let us say enclosed by closed surface of any closed surface of sigma A, that is therefore by Gaussian law. So therefore E is equal to sigma by 2EON, where E is there, N is the unit vector. So next, the final two topic is the field due to uniform and changed that has thin spherical shell. So field outside the shell. So if the field is outside the shell, so consider a point P outside the shell, and let us take here. So the Gaussian surface is E into 4πr². So therefore, sigma into 4πr² is by Gaussian law. So E into 4πr² is equal to sigma E by 4πr². So therefore, E is equal to sigma E is equal to pi by 4πeor² is the thing we get, where Q is greater than or less than 0. And next is field inside the shell. Here we will take same E into 4πr² is equal to 0, so where E becomes 0. So this is the important result, is the directly consequences of Gaussian law, which follows the Coulomb's law, and the experimental verification of this result confirms that 1πr² depends in Coulomb's law. 1πr² depends in the Coulomb's law, it confirms. So this was your chapter. the electric charges and fields. So okay friends, I think you have understand this chapter. So it concerns Gaussian's law, Coulomb's law, and many other topics I have explained. So I think you understand this chapter. So okay friends, I will see you in my next video. Like my video, comment on it, and subscribe my channel and coaching center for more videos of your girl standard. So okay friends, I will see you in my next video. Till then, take care, have a nice day, bye my friends.